Let us pray. O holy and gracious God, you have called us into this house of worship, that we might hold before us the vision of your love, the vision of your kingdom, and the glory that you call us to. As we baptize today, help us each to remember our own baptismal covenant. Help us to remember that we are your beloved children and that nothing can separate us from your love. We pray in the name of Jesus, who came that we might have life and have it more abundant. Amen. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be His kingdom, now and forever.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one Lord, God, all of us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God, Father, of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with you in the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel. Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 29 responsively by half verse. Ascribe to the Lord, you gods. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice.
The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor.
The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees.
The Lord breaks the cedar trees.
He makes Lebanon skip like a calf.
And Mount Hermon like a young olive.
The voice of the Lord splits the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees writhe
and strips the forests bare.
And in the temple of the Lord,
all are crying glory.
The Lord sits enthroned above the flood.
The Lord sits enthroned as King forevermore.
The Lord shall give strength to his people.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
As the people were filled with expectation and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heavens opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. For about 6 years, I guess, our youth took mission trips to Alaska every summer. I was fortunate enough to go on two occasions to be with our youth in a place called Manly Hot Springs. You've heard of that, haven't you? Manly Hot Springs is literally 100 miles down the end of a dirt road in a beautiful section of Alaska, where we were helping the Diocese of Alaska to build a camp and conference center. But during our time in Manly Hot Springs, we never had any running water. So whenever we bathed, we had to go down and jump into the inlet of a glacial river. Now, yes, it was August, but it's Alaska. So that water never got much above about 49 degrees. The kids loved it. The kids loved it. But every day I had to decide, am I going to go down there, jump into that inlet, wash my hair and my body, or am I just going to have to live with deep woods off, covering every part of my body for the rest of the day? Inevitably, I would go down and jump in with the kids every day, except the first day. I never went the first day. We would arrive, unpack the vans, set up camp, and the kids would immediately head off to the inlet, saying, "Come on, come on, let's go for a jump, let's go for a swim." And I'd always say, "No, not today. I'm not dirty yet. I'm not sweaty yet. I don't even have any bug spray on me yet. I can still remember that warm shower in Fairbanks. I'm not going today. I'll start going with you all tomorrow. I'm just not dirty yet." Well, some people ask me, you'll see where this is going in a second, I promise. Some people ask me quite often, why is it we baptize infants when they're not even dirty yet? When they haven't done anything precious and beautiful and perfect, why do they need to be baptized for the forgiveness of sin? What kind of sinning have they done? Shouldn't we wait until they grow up and get really dirty? But see, the point of infant baptism is that God says, "This child, this baby, is loved and welcome and forgiven even before they've done anything." Infant baptism is God saying, "I love this child first. I love this child knowing that she will do both good and bad. And I will steadfastly love her every day of her life. And more than that, because she is my child, I will give her the chance to restart over and over and over again." Regardless of the age we are baptized, baptism is a once and for all marking where we are claimed by God, declared the children of God, and given the opportunity to start over and over again. Now, as far as we know, Jesus is the only person who never needed his baptism. As the Son of God, so deeply connected to the will of his Father, Jesus lived a life and journeyed all the way to the cross without sin. If we define sin as that which separates us from God, Jesus was never separated from God. But for you and I, that's a different story. You and I cannot not sin. That's how they say it in the theology books. You and I cannot not sin. We are not capable of not sinning. Jesus shows us the perfect human life, but you and I, at our best, can only approximate that life. But part of the wonder of our baptisms is that God proclaims to us that we are loved and we are washed clean in spite of our sins. Ours is a religion of second chances. Now, when I was a kid, before there was Xbox and PlayStation, the great treat for me as a child was when my mother would allow me to walk to the local 7-Eleven with a pocket full of change to play the one and only pinball machine within a 5-mile radius. Now, this was the 70s, and the rock opera Tommy by The Who was a big rage those days. I see some heads going, uh-huh. I see some older heads going, uh-oh. Tommy was all the rage those days, and I wanted to be a pinball wizard. Now, I'm not a gambling man, but give me a bunch of quarters and a good old pinball machine, and I will spend every single one of them trying to beat the high score. Literally, at that 7-Eleven, I would stand there for hours trying to play and play until sometimes the guy behind the counter would ask me to leave. I really remember one day trying to sell my pocket knife to my next-door neighbor for 3 more quarters because I was this close to the high score. I just needed one more chance to reach that high score. Well, the promise of our faith, you baptized Christians, is that we metaphorically have a pocket full of quarters and all the chances to reach the high score we will ever need. The promise of our baptisms is that God knows our hearts, our shortcomings, our dark sides, our failings, and God loves us anyway. That's the message that lies at the heart of the gospel. We worship the God of second chances. God wipes the slate clean over and over again. No matter what the mistakes of our past, we can start anew. What a great message to hear as we begin a new year so full of potential and possibility. We get to start again. Every time we confess our sins, every time we repent, which literally means to turn around, every time we repent and ask forgiveness, every time we seek to genuinely amend our lives, we are reimmersed once again in the waters of baptism and washed clean. Because you see, folks, we are playing with Jesus' quarters that have been hard won on the wood of the cross. But they are given freely for all of us if we want something different for our lives. So as you begin the journey of 2016, let me give you one simple sentence that I invite you to use as the foundation of your life for this year. 3 words. God loves you. God loves you. No strings attached, no ifs, ands, and buts. God loves you yesterday, today, and tomorrow. So take those three words and stand on them as the foundation of your life and try again. Whatever it is you fall short of, try again, because you cannot fall but so far. That love will always catch you. Reach to be the person you aren't yet, but the person you want to be. If you need to forgive others in your life, then forgive them. Let go of the malice in your heart. Give them another chance, because God has given you one. If you need to be more patient, more understanding, more kind to the people around you, then try again. God loves you. You can keep playing for the high score. We've been washed in the waters of baptism once and for all time. We are not free from sin, but the promise of baptism is that sin does not own us. God owns us. We are the beloved children of God, the God of second chances. Amen. Please be seated. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life?
I will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world, which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in their life in Christ?
Yeah.
Then let us stand and join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people, and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
And let us now pray for this child who is to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver him, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open his heart to your grace and truth. Fill him with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep him in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach him to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send him into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring him to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We lift up in prayer the sick and those in need, remembering especially Doug Burgoyne, Bruce Duffy, Marshall Earle, Mary Harrison, Gwyn Jordan, Cece Lawson Manley, Will McCormick, Barbara Merchant, Holt Merchant, Luke Newcomb, Jim Parkinson, Julie Poitevant, Marv Presson, Keeling Roach, Francis Sargent, Bob Seiler, Blackwell Smith, and Lee Stevens. We also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially Jean Holland, Sharon Catlett, Patsy Sowers, and Alice Warman, who died recently, and the Reverend and Mrs. Richard Royal Baker III, Viola Lily Taylor, and Richard Wilson Gainsold Sr., in whose memory the flowers at the altar are given.
Grant, O Lord, that Teddy and all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated. If there are any kids out there who'd like to come up and see the baptism, they're invited to come on up and sit on the rug if you want to. The Lord be with you.
Also
with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Okay, come on, God. Will you let me take him? Yes. Oh, yes. Theodore Rawlings, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good boy. You're just a good boy. You're a good boy. Theodore Rawlings, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed this upon your servant, the forgiveness of sin, and have raised him to the new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Amen. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified. Proclaim his resurrection and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Please stand. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Good morning, St. James's.
Morning.
As we walk Teddy up and down the aisle to welcome him into our family, I welcome all of you today, especially Teddy's friends and family who are here with him this morning. It's a special day. We've had 5 baptisms today. We had 4 at the 9 o'clock service, and it's a great, great day. Great day. It's always the most joyful thing in the life of the church when we welcome new members into the body of Christ. Several announcements for you. Wednesday night programming returns this Wednesday with evening prayer at 5:30 in the chapel, dinner at 6 in the Misha House, and the return of our Wednesday night programmings, Pilgrim's Path for all those who are new to the church, and our Christian Journey class. Now this week, our Christian Journey class has a very special guest, the Honorable Frank Wolfe, former congressman from Virginia, will be here with us to teach a class on Wednesday night. Frank's passion, his avocation, may I say, in all the work that he's done for so many years, is the persecution of Christians around the world. And he does a lot to raise awareness about that issue. And Frank's an incredible speaker, so I hope you will come to be with us Wednesday night as we welcome him to St. James's. Don't forget as well that our Martin Luther King Evensong is coming up this Sunday, the 17th of January at 5 p.m. with all the choirs of St. James's as well as the concert choir of Norfolk State University. and it is just a joyful, wonderful service. So I hope you'll come and be with us. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because in Jesus Christ, our Lord, you have received us as your sons and daughters, made us citizens of your kingdom, and given us the Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with James and all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray together. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Tread lightly upon the earth, for it is the dwelling place of God. Deal gently with all living things, for they were created by God. Live simply, humbly, and joyfully, for you too are a beloved child of God. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you this day and always. Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God.